Sup guys, Heiking here, bringing you my final reaction to Game of Thrones Season 8, Episode 6, The Iron Throne, apparently it's called. So, yeah, let's just get this over with. As Robert Baratheon once said, you know, give me something for the pain and let me die. So let's just get this tragedy over with. This misfire of crap made by D&D. God, I hope those guys get fired from Star Wars. I really do. Like, they really dropped the ball on this. So, yeah. Bloody tragedy. Anyway, here we go. Previously on Game of Thrones. Trying to get closer to the camera so my face is in there. I can't even get excited watching this intro. It's really depressing when you consider the fact that episode 2 was the best written episode of the season so far. Like, that's because it's done by the guy who knew his stuff with Game of Thrones and the books and that, so why they wouldn't let him take over as showrunner after season 4, I don't know. We're starting with Tyrion walking. Looking depressed. Is that snow? Or I'm going to say it's ash. It's ash falling into the sky. Which, you know, still doesn't make sense because it should have been snow, considering what happened at the end of season 7 when it was starting to snow in King's Landing and it's suddenly cut to it. It's all beautiful and dusty and deserty and light and... That's not a pretty image. That is so fucked up. Who the hell is that? Is that a survivor? Yeah, it's a survivor, right? Or is it one of those soldiers? Back was completely what, burnt or ripped off? Like, what was that? I swear, if it's not revealed that it was Bran who did all of this, like wagging into people and just using them to do all this crap, I'm gonna be disappointed. That's gonna give memories to Davos if he sees it. Yep. I bet you will. That's depressing as fuck. This is where he lived for the majority of his life, like off the Castle Rock, isn't it, right? I assume, right? Or so it's his city, it's his people. Honestly, I think Book Tyrion wouldn't give a shit, because Book Tyrion made it very clear he wants to like kill everyone in King's Landing, so after he got after that whole trial fiasco, so I don't know. The fuck? Someone kill this douchebag. No, no, they gave up. Grey Worm's a douche. I'm sorry, he's a prick. You're the fucking king though! Say something! It's gonna be like the vision, falling on the. Oh, is this the map room? Walking. More walking. What's that? Oh, is that a torch? He's looking for Cersei and Jaime. If one of them is still alive, that would be impressive. Oh god, the rubble. Oh god, there was a way out. No, this happened after, didn't it, when the rubble fell, like. How is this place not buried in, like. Look how much open space there is there. Are you fucking kidding me? Look how much space there is where nothing even fell. Like, if they just, if you're telling me if they just moved a bit back, they would have survived, yeah? Wow, that's terrible. Oh, he's golden hand. It's sad, but at the same time, it's so dumb. They could have survived, they just moved a bit. That's so stupid. Arya was on a fucking horse leaving the city. What's she doing back here? Hardly seen any interaction of John and Arya. Another reason why the season sucks. I'm sorry, the Dothraki are meant to be fucking dead, right? Episode 3, what essentially we're seeing is the end of the Dothraki as we know it, or whatever, to that effect, as D&D said in their little behind the scenes. But then cut to episode 5, and now 6, and look how many have survived! Because it only looked like 5 or 20 of them survived, but no, it's a whole fucking army! And the Unsullied, where the fuck were they? The inconsistency and continuity in this is astonishingly bad. How the fuck did this prick get here? He was in the city killing people and now he's here. How the fuck did he teleport? Oh, that's a beautiful shot. That was epic. Wings of Madness. Look at that! blood of my blood. How the fuck can they hear her from all the way there? That's a cool shot. Where the hell did they get that flag? You're a cunt. Master of War. Oh god, has that ever been such a thing? No, they haven't. All the people of the world, what? By burning them alive, yeah? From Winterfell to Dawn, my god. Cough, oh my god. Some isles to there. Danny's going all Hitler and shit, man. It's terrifying. Arya is pissed. And Miss Sunday's dead. Who the fuck did the braiding on your hair? Fucking Catherine Everdeen her fucking ass, man. Someone shoot an arrow into her fucking heart, like. Oh god, my battery's about to run out on my laptop. There we go. Ugh, sorry about that. What's Tyrion doing? I hope Tyrion says he betrayed her, like. Fuck you, you committed the worst of treason. Fuck you! This bitch needs to die. She needs to die horribly. John, all of this could have probably been avoided if you just, if you just penetrated her when she wanted it. And it all would have been good. Properly. Is she gonna kill Tyrion then, or? Oh shit, where the fuck did she go? Oh, you wanker. Yeah. Oh, you don't say. Was this after or before you saw her, like, flying in and burning everyone to death? I'm curious where Bronn is. Just have him magically appear and... So he gives his sword there, where's he going? Yeah, Tarly's can vouch for that. Varys was his closest friend, that's sad. Oh, wow. No, it's blackness. Barricade. Yeah. Fuck do you mean you can't justify what happened? Did you hear what she said? It's not over. I'm sure Tyrion understands a bit of Valyrian, so he would know what she said, like... Maybe. Please say no. yeah, you... Yeah. Those people deserve that, I mean. Oh, like hell. Having ashes falling down a city is not paradise. I mean, love is the death of duty. Oh, he said it. Shame that you never talked to about him with Danny. Tyrion trying to convince John the killer. Yeah. Aren't you listening, you twat? Nope. And they'll burn for it. Thank you. This is like some shit out of Bloodborne. I want to say Dark Souls, but I've never played it, so. Which is a game I do want to get, like, the trilogy pack, play that.